What's good, y'all? Welcome back to our channel, Chrissyy Talks. Y'all come in Chrissyy. Let's go ahead and talk about this shit. So, Jazz has been a lot more active on social media since Tae's been on live at 23KB and was a little bit affectionate. So after this live was reposted, Jazz went on her Twitter and said, "You ever look at a motherfucker like, ew, I really fuck with that?" And good laugh though. Just know I'll never, ever, ever fail y'all like that. She then said the private line and said, "By the way, this tweet has nothing to do with looks. Adults will understand." So just in case y'all motherfuckers are not adults, let me explain this. So we already know that Jazz is a private person, hence her tweet saying that private life. So what's making her post that regretful tweet like, ew, it's more so because of how Tae's acting with her new boo, aka her friend with benefits, the dick that she's currently riding. I don't know what you want to call it. Actually, Tae did post on her snap when somebody asked her, "Are you crushing?" and she said yes on him. So I don't know if this is really just friends or if they just fucking or if he's trying to pursue her. I really do not know. It seems like he's more caught up in his rap career, but shit happens behind closed doors that I do not know about. But yeah, so Jazz saying this is not her way of saying that Tae is ugly or unattractive. It's just that she doesn't really fuck with how she's acting and being on live and getting her ass grabbed. I was about to say her ass ate. Her ass grabbed and her tongue in another nigga's mouth. So it's really just more so Tae putting it out there that she's fucking with somebody else. And but we gonna talk about it. I really wanna know what you guys think, because I understand what Jazz is trying to say, because we know at this point she's coming from a place of hurt, because she has not been this active on social media since this, you know, live incident happened. My thing is, on one hand, Tae has the right to do whatever the fuck she wants because she is single. At the same time, I do feel like she did a little bit too much on live, but it's like, she has her rights. She felt like she wanted to do it. I just can't tell if she was doing this to be petty or not. Because it's like, first you did this post and then delete. Then both of y'all went on live without showing who's in the background. Like, and then you guys went on live together and was all of a sudden being way more publicly affectionate than you guys were before, when y'all was trying to be more secretive. So I can't tell like what Tae's intentions were when she went on live and did all this shit, but I do feel like she did just a little bit too much. Now, Jazz, I understand it's hard to see your ex-girlfriend being touched up and felt up on like that on live. I get it, and you know, she's still healing. Like, just a month ago, she came out with the video explaining her breakup, and she said in that video, she's still healing. Like, you could tell they're still emotional, but at the same time, Tae is single. At the same time, you basically let Tae go out of your relationship. So it's like, I don't know, because when it comes down to it, it's a respect factor. So it's like, Jazz needs to respect Tae and the fact that she's a single woman, but it's like, does Tae also need to respect Jazz and the fact that she's still healing and their supporters? I'm pretty sure that's why Jazz says, "I will never fail y'all like that," because at the same time as Jazz and Tae are both separately going through their healing process, so are some supporters, believe it or not, as dumb as that sounds. Now, Jazz continued on tweeting saying, "Y'all showing out with the love in my DMs. I fuck with my gang the long way. I'm so glad I'm my own person. Motherfuckers quick to follow the leader." So I don't know if she was like calling Tae a follower, basically. And then she retweets a series of tweets where people are basically trying to slide into her DMs or on her face. I thought this was a little bit petty, just to show up like, bitch, I got people in my DMs too. I got people trying to taste the poom poom too. Like, what you mean? But yeah, so I felt like Jazz was putting out these tweets as a reminder to everybody, to Tae and to herself. That's like, bitch, I got it. Like, what you think? What you thought? I could never lose. What you thought? Hey. And they got in our alignment, of course. Now, on top of being more active on Twitter and Instagram and Snapchat, she also posted her first video back on YouTube since she posted her explanation of her breakup with Tae. Now, this video is just her getting off her braces. Final fucking leash. She had them shits on for like 10 years. So yeah, it seems like Jazz is officially back on YouTube, at least consistently, and it seems like she's finna go hard. Like, I really felt like her seeing and Tae just kind of snapped her out of this healing process, and she's just like, alright bitch, it's on now. So following her first upload back on YouTube, she goes on Twitter and she asks her supporters who they want to see her collaborate with on YouTube. Eventually, Armon, Trey, and Queen Naija step into the building, and this is gonna be pretty big because they haven't collaborated in a long time. They literally all went their separate ways and had their own relationships, had their own family, literally. Now, the Shade Room Teens reposted Jazz's tweets and Armon, Trey's, and Queen's basically announced that they are possibly going to collaborate on YouTube in the future together. Now, somebody commented on the Shade Room Teens and they said, "Trying to use the people for them views. Tae said, and they say, I'm clout chasing. So I guess Tae threw a little bit of shade on Jazz or whatever, because a lot of people say that Tae is clout chasing and she was just using Jazz. And this idea kind of faded out a little bit, but then it really been brought back up since Tae was on live with 23KB. I mean, I think it's shitty to say Jazz made you. She made her own audience. People decided to go over and follow Tae. Whether you did that because you fuck with Jazz, that's on you. But there's some people who actually genuinely support her. So I mean, I just feel like, honestly, keep bringing that up to her face, it's just pointless. So when the Shade Room Teens reposted Tae's comment, Tae said, I'm laughing because she talked all that shit about them just to be back in their face. I guess she needs to revamp that channel back up. Okay, I'm done. I just thought this was funny. And it was a fan page for Jazz actually that commented. I mean, Armon and Trey and Jazz did have that fallout before. Maybe that must be what she referring to about talking shit about them. And Jazz said, bro, thank you. Y'all know we fell the fuck out. Me and my niggas know how this shit go. We are good. That don't got shit to do with now. So it seemed like Tae tried to throw some shade on Jazz, and Jazz wasn't even the one herself to respond to it. It was a Jazz fan page, and I do remember them falling out. I don't remember too much into the details, but I remember they were no longer posting videos together. So I mean, shit happens. Like, not trying to call all of us fake bitches, but we've all fallen out with our friends and we've all talked our shit, because I mean, let's face it, there's things about everybody that we love and there's some things that it's like. And then Jazz posted this on her Instagram story saying, LMAO bro, come on, y'all know I've been doing this shit since I was 16, Vine and all that. So she's showing out like, bitch, I don't need to go back to these niggas for a come up on my channel, like, I'm little perfect. This is when Tae went on her snap and said she has the right to speak. Literally, she has freedom of speech, and nobody said anything when Jazz went on Twitter, posted all that shit.
Whatever happened to freedom of speech? We don't do that no more? Like, okay, y'all let her get her freedom of speech when she was dissing me, but when I have freedom of speech, it's World War 18. Okay, I'm done being childish, for real. I'm sorry for being childish. A wise old lady once told me that it's gonna end how it started, and you can't get mad at the fact that it's ending how it started because I warned you, type shit. And I'm just like, I'm thinking back at it like, you right, you show motherfucking right. Y'all know how that shit started for me? Like, it was hell. So, but once that shit is over with, only people that's gonna survive in your corner are the people that truly support you, are the people that truly rock with you, and the people that truly see you for who you are.
She also said she may make a Q&A and assumptions post. She actually said this once after Jazz posted those tweets, and then again saying she's gonna make it an assumptions video.
Oh, you know what? I'm gonna make a YouTube video. Assumptions. Because y'all got so many assumptions. Especially that Jazz made you shit. No, she ain't made me. She ain't make me. My mom made me. The fuck? She introduced me to something new. Yes. The fuck? And if you go look through all them videos, baby, you not doing them alone. So, and I never discredit that girl. So, get out. Please, thank you.
Also, I don't know if she's still gonna make this, because I believe somebody did say that she didn't have to, like, she shouldn't be falling into this, making a video, and she said, bitch, you right. And she also says that though she does not discredit Jazz and what she's done for her, Jazz didn't make her, bitch, her mama did. Does say that Jazz didn't do all this content by herself. And she got a point, like, her and Jazz were both putting in that time and work to make content together. So it's like, it's not like Tae was just sitting there, sitting pretty. Jazz later on tweets, turn your grinds up, all that other shit gonna come up later. After all I done did, and after all the relationships people I've introduced you to, even fell out with because of you, and this how you doing me. Close that back door. So I feel like her saying, oh, this is how you doing me, it's just like her saying, like, you're embarrassing me, or, you know, you're over here showing out with this other man. And it's like, again, we talked about this, and some people in my comments have said, like, there's no timestamp for her to move on. And Tae kind of stated that she did try in this relationship to piece it together. Jazz was putting in that energy. So it's like, what the fuck are you gonna do? You know what I'm saying? Like, eventually Tae's gonna move on. I guess Jazz just needed a little bit more time, and she wished that Tae would have respected that for her and her supporters. But it's like, you could definitely see that there's more going on behind closed doors. Cause we all thought they were good for a minute, but there was tension in the beginning of the breakup when Tae posted those Instagram stories up. There's tension before Jazz posted that video, and there's tension now. So clearly there's something going on. And I mean, this is just what happens when people still love each other and still have feelings for each other. That feeling of love can turn to a feeling of frustration so quick when somebody that you really love is like you know, doing some shit that hurts you. Interestingly enough, Tae's brother posted on his story saying, "Crazy how fame and money can fuck up relationships." Tae's cousin said, "Only reason I'm dropping a YouTube video Sunday is because y'all think y'all know so much but don't know what happened behind closed doors. So since Jazz got something to say, I'ma air it out." Now I'm like, I don't know how Tae would feel about that, because this is your cousin. Like, it's not your relationship or your place to really go on YouTube and air some shit out. But it definitely looks like there's some shit that's going on behind closed doors. And I did think it was interesting that Jazz responded to Tae going on live and being with somebody else, but she has yet to respond to the cheating allegations made by her ex and her ex's ex. I did want to quickly mention that there's some people in my comments who are saying, of course Tae's going back to some dick. Of course she's going back straight after this. I think that's really weird to say that of course she's going back to a man, like it's expected or that's what she's supposed to do or she was always straight. That don't make no sense. I thought Tae was bisexual and I'm pretty sure she is. Like, she dated Jazz, she had an ex-boyfriend before Jazz. I did find this in a Q&A video where somebody asked her, are you into boys or girls?
Are you more into girls or boys? Jazz.
Good answer. I mean, sexuality don't got nothing to do with it, but it's like, I just thought those comments were weird, as if bisexuality does not exist. But anyway, we can clearly see that there's more going on behind closed doors. I don't know what's gonna happen next. Like, if everything stopped at them explaining their breakups, it would have been Gucci, but it's just turning a little bit ugly, because they're talking about you're cordial with each other, but that's what everybody says when they low-key don't like a bitch. But that's the end of my video. I hope you guys enjoyed. Comment down what you guys think below. Do you guys think that Tae took it too far going on live with 23kb? Do you guys think that Jazz is tripping and Tae is single and can do whatever the fuck she wants? Do you think there was some cheating going on? Comment down what you guys think below. Follow me on Instagram and my Snapchat at @chrissyy, 2 S's 2 Y's. I love and appreciate you guys. I'm 5 minutes late to my class and I'll see y'all in my next video. Bye guys.